Right, hello again everybody, Kylie Roo right here with the first episode of my playthrough of State of Decay Year 1 Survival Edition Lifeline. Now for those of you that don't know, Lifeline is a slightly different emphasis in the game. You play as the commander of a group of soldiers in the city of Danforth, which is nearby to Trumbull Valley. In fact, I think if you look at the road signs, you will see signs to Danforth on the road signs in the Trumbull Valley State of Decay Year 1 Survival Edition story mode map. So we are have been tasked with rescuing vital assets in Danforth and returning them to the military base. And I'm hoping it's not going to take too long to load, but you get straight in with the action at the beginning of this game, so I just wanted to do a little bit of an intro over the loading screen here.
Stay back. We will open fire. All right. Diplomacy's over, fuckers.
Greyhound's left the doghouse.
So there is much more of an emphasis in this game on using guns and military tactics to kill zombies, and you have a military base that you need to defend. I don't think I've ever managed to kill them all at range before.
Greyhound 1 to doghouse. We're still here. We had to abandon our vehicle.
Medevac is ready to go, but right now, Greyhound 2 is busy fucking up my LZ. Get over there and secure that extraction point. We're not going to be rescuing anybody if we can't even land a damn helo.
I like Doghouse, actual. Okay, so what are we doing then? We are making our way to Greyhound 1, which is the code name given to the base in Danforth. But they are in trouble, so we need to go and help them out. So we need to get there pretty sharpish. I don't know whether you saw at the top of the... Is it this one? No, it's the next one. I don't know whether you saw at the top of the... the top of the screen there, a number popped up. That basically tells you how close you are to a siege, because what happens is you get periodic sieges on your home base by the zombies. So we arrive in the middle of one. LZ under attack.
This is the LZ, but we're not landing a helo on those Zeds.
Nope. Could be fun, though. Right, so, as you can see, we've got quite an impressive base here, but it does need shoring up because they are being attacked. So we need to help them out. You meet one of my favourite characters from the game. Okay, we need to stop fanning about and get inside and help them out now, because they really are in trouble here. We don't want to lose anybody so close to the beginning of the game. Okay, let's get on it then. Let's get it on. Come on, come on. There's one there that you can take out. That's it. Good girl. Hold on to your sphincters, dudes. We are gonna get through this. Really? Oh, crying out loud. Can you not just kill a few zombies? My zombie. No, mine. Get off. My zombie. I want to kill him. Mine. Look, there's one behind you. Eat that one. Kill that one. Yeah, alright. Right, where are we? There we are. Troops in contact. Need to harden this position. LZ is secure.
Greyhound 2. I thought we lost you.
You never call, you never write.
It's just the two
Greyhound
of us
2.
Now.
Yeah.
I don't even know what happened to my comms. Everything went down so fast.
This whole mission is assed up. We dug in here like they said, but these bastards got in here anyway.
Someone called Kyle, that's my name. Okay, Greyhound 2, Evelyn held things together.
Finally, I got a helo en route. Get on the road and pick up that high-value asset before we have to go wheels up.
Roger, you have our position. Tell the bird to land inside the fence and get the doctor on board.
Roger
okay.
That. Maybe one thing will go right today.
So we've got to go... Shut the fuck up. We've got to go rescue some high-value assets. But first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to just check a few things here. Brass have given him... Oh, okay, so she's actually been given a promotion. Awesome. So the bases work slightly differently here. We start off by having a mess hall, a barracks, ops centre, and supply room, all of which need repairing. So we're going to get straight on and do that right here. Okay, and we also have a landing zone, which we need to repair. So basically what happens... Oh, we haven't got enough materials. Oh, good. We are going to have to go find some materials then. That's just what I wanted to see. So basically what we've got to do is we get explosives that we can restock, like we did last time on both sides. And we've got outposts we can set up. And the helipad, yes. So basically what happens is we can radio in for supplies to be dropped at the helipad. We can get drops of materials, guns, weapons, ammunition, etc. So we are going to... That's 7, 6. Get rid of those. We can top back up on these. And you might notice that actually removing stuff from the cache here doesn't actually decrease your influence. You don't need to spend money, because obviously it would be weird if you could only, you know, you were an officer commanding military operation and you had to stock up on influence to be able to take stuff out to go on missions. So we are going to take... Let me take this one, actually. And we are going to go and rescue a high-value asset from a crash site. Actually, you know what I'm going to do first? Quite often over here there are building materials, and like I said, you can still set up outposts. So I am going to pop in here just to see whether there are any building materials, because we need some to be able to repair our landing zone. So we're just going to search in here. And then what I'll probably do is I'll set this up as an outpost and call for a scavenger to come over from the base just across the way there. Yep, okay, so we've got that. So we're going to call for a scavenger. We're going to grab this and put it in the back of the truck. Same drill as it was in the story mode. So we're going to bung that in there. We are going to get out of the way of that zombie. Dudes, can you just come and defend me for a minute? We are going to take this as well. I didn't set it up as a fucking outpost. I'm a spanner. I bet you guys were screaming at me, weren't you? Fuck it. Oh well. Well, never mind. We got the building materials anyway, which was the important thing. So, we're going to drop these back off at home. Might set it up as an outpost anyway. You can set ones up as an outpost that aren't supplying resources. They just don't give you periodic resources in your inventory. So, in fact, I might do that. Basically, it's just a... It's just somewhere with a supply locker, and it just increases the safe zone. So I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to set this place up as an outpost. I'm a fucking idiot. I shouldn't have done. Oh
well. An outpost on this location ASAP.
So as you can see, getting people to come and search and building outposts, I believe both still cost influence. So we're going to repair our landing zone. Right, so as you can see, same as before, we've got an increased safe zone radius. And we're going to pop in here and we're going to set up traps to give us an even bigger safe zone radius. Look at that now. That is pretty nice. Pretty nice. Would have been even nicer if I'd been less of a fucking idiot and remembered to do it before I took the construction materials out. But never mind. Never mind. Can we just get through here without crashing too many times, please? That would be really nice. There we are, landing zone complete already. Can we order stuff in yet? Yeah, so here we are. You can get supply drops of various things which do cost influence, because depending on how well you do in your role as commander of Greyhound 1, it depends on how much support you get from the brass. How sort of operatively successful you are. Depends on the influence you have with them, obviously. So.
That used to be a helicopter? I've seen worse.
Greyhound 1 to Doghouse. We're at the objective. The Hilo is a wreck. No visual on the asset.
My zombie.
I want headshots on all tangos. Standing.
Hold on to your sphincters, guys. Sphincters. Let's do it, guys. Let's do it. Roll out of the way. Kill them all. Kill them all. Get him. Die. Okay, then. I got a little bit nibbled on there, so let's just pop one of those in one of those.
These guys were soldiers. You still think this is funny, Vince?
No, Sergeant. No way.
Doghouse to Greyhound 1. We're showing that asset is not at your position.
Confirmed, sir. No one here matches the ID, alive or dead.
Well then, expand your search to the surrounding buildings.
Yes, sir. Greyhound 1 out.
I'm gonna take this now because these cars are awesome.
We're gonna search these structures for friendlies, so check your fire.
Okay, so we've got to search the surrounding area now because we are looking for a man called Dr. Horn who was researching this crisis when it first started. Let's just... Come on, I wanna... Get... Right. Let's just stop here. Might be meds in here as well, which we could really do with. But I don't think our asset that we're looking for... What the fuck was that? Seriously. I've not heard that before. We'll investigate it properly in a second. I want to search this place first. No, we've got some tablets though, that'll do. We'll find out what that noise was now. Cool, he didn't have a good time, did he? Right, so there's nobody in here anyway. Let's get out of here then and we'll search the next building along. Was that just the helicopter exploding? Is that all that was? No, I have no idea what that explosion was. Is that a car like that before? Car wasn't like that before, was it? Wasn't that the one that we drove here in? What the hell happened to it? I have no idea. Right, leadership level 2. Awesome. So we're leveling up our lass here. I'll introduce everybody when we get back to base.
Hello?
Anybody in here? Again, running into an establishment in the middle of a zombie apocalypse and shouting at the top of your voice. Not your smartest move, I don't think. Okay then, let's see. Is Dr. Horn in here? No, but there might be some food, so let's have a look. We'll take the cooking supplies, I think. We'll take that because we're a bit low on those. We haven't got any room for the Molotov.
Gotta be more careful next time.
So we've got more cooking supplies. So we're going to take those as well.
We're done here.
But this place is clear tavern. more fireball. What am I actually... I got that nail bar thing. I might drop the nail bar off in the boot of the car as well and grab the... Did I actually misread that? Was this medicine in here, not food? We haven't actually finished searching it. Medicine! I'm going to take this. Out of the way, dude. Yeah, out of the way. Seriously. Guys in this game can be just as bad as Lydia. Skyrim players will get that reference. Right, good. We've got lots of medical supplies. Can get some food supplies as well from next door. And I'm going to stick that nail bar in there and pick out and take out those fire bombs just in case we come across anything that needs to be burnt. Okay. So this it's interesting. This game is much more claustrophobic. This mode. Well, I think it is anyway. Because, and I'll tell you why. You're in like a much much smaller area. You're in a much smaller area. The city of Danforth is, I think, might not look small. Maybe it's not actually smaller. I don't know. I think it's smaller than where you were before. And the places to search are much closer together. But it is more dangerous, this game. I believe it is anyway. I've had a much higher attrition rate of characters in this game than I have in the story mode. Here is, that's where he is, but I think I'm going to go down here and I'm going to search down here so we know where our chap is. But I'm going to search this place, and I think I can set this up as an outpost. I can set this up as an outpost.
I need an outpost on this location ASAP.
So you see what this will do is this will ensure that we can continue to call artillery strikes down.
Anybody in here?
On Zeds, etc. Right, searching. So we've got construction materials and we've got fuel. So what do we want first? We are yellow on the fuel, so I'm going to grab the fuel and I'm going to pop this in the boot. I don't know whether we have enough space to take any of the construction materials. No, we don't, so we'll leave that as that for now, but we've got some construction materials that we can come back and get from here. Boom. Okay, then. Get in the car. You know what? Actually, I can carry one on my back. I can carry one on my back. Get out of the way. Get in the car. Thank you. Okay, so the good doctor, I believe, where did I see him? Oh, he's in the car wash building thing, I think. He's in here anyway.
You must be Dr. Thomas Horn. We're here to get
turn to mission area. I literally just found him.
I'm not sure that I should.
Doghouse actual to Greyhound 1. That helicopter is moments from your position. We need you to move.
Okay.
We're loading up the asset now.
We've got Dr. Horn.
That's good news, Greyhound 1. They're scratching at the damn gates over here.
So we need to get out of Dodge. Wrong way. Get Dr. Horn to the LZ. It's worth our lives to get him back safely. Not sure if I agree with that, but never mind. Let's do it. Stop. Thank you. You need to not hit my own traps. It's the key thing here.
All done.
Okay, so we've got some construction materials, got some medicine, got some food, etc. And we're about to get some more construction materials up in here.
Dust off in 2 minutes. Where are you taking me?
Out of here. Does it really matter?
We're taking you to HQ. Apparently your research is our best hope for curing this thing.
Let me spell it out. I'm infected. One of those things bit me. I'm a dead man. You're wasting your time.
I'm not here to decide who's a waste of time. I'm here to get you out.
What if I turn while we're airborne? Attack the pilot. Bring us all down. What good did I do then?
Hey, whoa!
My time is up. Use your helicopter to save somebody else.
Doctor, no!
So I guess we call off the medevac.
Well, there we are. Now what are we going to do? Yes, indeed.
Who gave that doctor access to a weapon?
We have a lot of dead soldiers here, sir. We're now securing all weapons we can find.
Well, it's too fucking late now, isn't it? Why don't you just hand your rifles over to the Zeds? Save us all some trouble.
Sir, what's the plan now?
Just stand by while I unfuck this problem you created.
Sir, this entire area is exposed to the enemy. Our ammo won't last forever.
Shore up your position, soldier. Long as you don't fuck it up any worse, we can keep you supplied by air. Just stand by and don't let anyone else die. Doghouse out.
Right, so Dr. Horn, who we came to rescue, committed suicide because he had been bitten. So, let's have a look at what we've got here. Who have we got in the base? We have Alicia Hawks, who is our commanding officer. Commands the entire operation and of base Black Friday. So we can automatically set a weapon specialization here. So I think what we are going to go for is we're going to go for assault rifles, and we are going to choose the focus aim special technique. Okay then, so who else have we got? We have we've got Alicia Hawks, who is just pretty standard. She's got good shooting skill at the moment. She's got cardio, etc. Pretty average, apart from the shooting. She is sniper qualified, went through intensive training in marksmanship and decision making that defines a qualified sniper. She made a bad call in the heat of battle that cost lives, was never officially blamed for the incident, but can't let go of it. He has become extra cautious as a result, and got basic training. Went through the same training gauntlet that shapes every new soldier. Came out with essential combat and survival skills and the ability to jog all day carrying a full pack. Well, I'm sure we'll put that to the test. So her second in command is Kilo Hannah Young, who, what do we got here? He's got basic training, lived in the South Pacific, got every imaginable shot whilst travelling in the Pacific, no disease going to get by this immune system. So I think that means that basically in-game he's got a increased immunity to disease and that sort of thing. Family back home. Has been out of contact with spouse and kids since the outbreak began, constantly dealing with the frayed nerves and intrusive thoughts. That would be horrible, being away from your family. That would be really horrible. Level-headed, a dependable person who can step outside of the situation and make the right call without getting too emotionally involved. So there we are. Worked with Major Hawks. Oh yes, I forgot there was like the little bio thing here. Worked with Major Hawks for the past 5 years and has been her most trusted colleague and advisor. Has 3 daughters back in Hawaii. So this is Alicia's now. Sorry, I should have done this before. Transferred to the military police stateside after being cleared of a friendly fire incident. Never wanted to hold the lives of her fellow soldiers in her hands again. Now all bets are off. So we have Vince Royale Vincent. Didn't survive a hurricane in Louisiana to be killed by this shit. Laughs in the face of disaster, because what else can you do? Absolutely. Basic training, martial artist. So he's a fitness expert. So one thing that sort of scuppered me a little bit in my playthrough of the story mode was the fact that actually I didn't have a fitness expert when I built a gym. So we've got a fitness expert now. Joker. Can't resist the urge to crack a joke even at the least appropriate times. Can be a lot of fun. Can also annoy the shit out of people. I can sympathise, buddy. People just don't appreciate a good sense of humour anymore. Storm survivor. Lived on the Gulf Coast as a child and spent months as a refugee from a terrible hurricane. Learned to be smart and self-efficient. We've got Evelyn Finch. Grew up on a ranch in Montana. Can field dress a deer in a minute and a half. That's good to know. Trophy hunter. I've got a huge collection of heads mounted on the walls of my cabin. Don't worry, they're mostly animal heads. Bonus for firearms. Curses constantly. Curses like a sailor, especially when talking to sailors. I know the feeling. Family traditions. Did everything a certain way back home. Can't imagine why anybody would want to do things differently. Fair enough. And basic training. So what's her... Can we view her stats, or do we have to... Oh yes, there we are. So she's got bonuses to shooting as well. So we might actually be able to choose a specialty for her also. And we've got Kyle Mosley. In case you guys didn't know, my first name was Kyle, which is where Kylie Rude came from. Barroom Brawler. Sir, doesn't take much.
Army personnel in need of assistance. Transmitting coordinates now.
Here we are, so we can go and rescue some army personnel shortly. Barroom Brawler. It doesn't take much to set you off once you've got a couple of shots in. Oh, okay, yes. And what was this? Knocked a girl up right before he enlisted. Found out during training. Has never met the kid. Knowing him, it's probably for the best. Charming. So he gets bonus to melee. Works out constantly. Obsessed with getting huge. So he's got powerhouse and bonus stamina. He owes child support. His ex owns a good chunk of his paycheck. He says he's caught up, but she would disagree. And basic training. And Dr. Horn, who is dead. Okay then. So thank you very much for watching this first episode of Lifeline. We will pick up in the next episode. I think we've got some soldiers to go and rescue over here. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. God bless and keep gaming.